Hello friends, welcome back to Let's Chat, a special segment of the Plug in India channel where we talk about interesting startups. And now we have for you the EVSE, the Electric Vehicle Supply Equipment Sector. And from that, we have Mr. Santosh with us, who is a co-founder in Bright Blue. This is an interesting startup which is making electric vehicle supply equipment right here in India. Santosh, we know that you and your team were part of DriveAmp, who engineered Made in India EVSEs. While most other companies are importing their equipment from outside, you guys have been doing it all yourself. So tell us a little bit about yourself. Tell us a little bit about Bright Blue, and how did you switch from the earlier company, which was DriveAmp?
Yeah, so thanks so much. So as I said, so my name is Santosh Ram, and I had actually started DriveAmp back in 2016 with two of my other co-founders. And we had actually built the entire technology stack for an EV charging station over several iterations back when we were working in Intel Makers Lab. And we had actually worked on multiple projects in EV charging in India over the last 3 years. So in 2019, we had actually merged our business operations with a Netherlands-based company called Asia Electric, forming the new brand Bright Blue. So this actually resulted in us bringing together a team with niche expertise in all organizational departments, as well as experience in global leading EV markets. Our CEO, Mr. Vibren van der Vaart, has over 7 years experience in the European as well as Indian EV market, and has helped set up several collaborations between Indian and Netherlands-based companies. We also have Mr. Yash Chitalia, who joined our core team, having worked for 5 years in EV Box North America. He was one of the first employees there, and he's for 5 years there, and he's actually helped the ecosystem evolve in the North American market. So EV Box, as you know, is already one of the global leading charging infrastructure companies. And we are very excited to have Yash on board and bringing a wealth of experience into our core team. So coming to our mission at Bright Blue, so we aim to provide global industry leading charging solutions to our customers and make charging easy, accessible and affordable. We own and control the entire charging technology stack, both the hardware, which includes the AC charging stations, as well as the software, which includes the admin dashboard and the mobile application. And we have an in-house engineering team taking care of the development of both of these aspects.
That's awesome, Santosh. Let's take a deep dive right into the product itself, the EVSE. Tell us about the top five features of the Bright Blue EVSE.
So we have developed a 7 kW AC wall box, which we have called Jolt. So this is actually a Type 2 charger compliant with the IEC 62196 standard. So most of the EV vehicles that are being launched in the market today, such as Tata Nexon, MG ZS EV, as well as the Hyundai Kona, all follow the Type 2 charging standard for AC charging. So we actually have an inbuilt cable already provided with the charger. And we have actually shifted from a screen-based architecture back when we were working in DriveAmp to keep simplicity in the newer models. So the charger is also OCPP 1.6J compliant, and it comes with a certified kilowatt hour meter for billing, as well as transactional data information. The charger has a programmable LED light, which is used as a visual indicator. And we have actually programmed the LEDs to actually give out a lot more status information compared to the chargers in the market. So for example, if the charger goes in an error mode, so based on the frequency of the flashing of the LED, the type of error can actually be found out, whether it's a grounding error or whether it's an overvoltage error or things like that. There is also status indicators that show whether the charger has lost internet connectivity. And in those cases, the data is actually stored offline until the internet actually comes back. The charger comes with an option for SIM card as well as Wi-Fi. So based on the user's requirements, we will provide the charger with the SIM card. Or if the user already has a Wi-Fi at his location, the charger can easily be configured at the time of commissioning. So the device also has a lot of error detections, which is compliant with European standards. So things like overvoltage, undervoltage, surge protection, earth wire detection, the temperature, which especially is a problem in case the cables are not fastened properly and there's a little bit of vibrations coming in. So to detect those as well, we have ensured and safety checks in place.
Since your charger uses a Type 2 connector, Santosh, we assume that it charges cars like the eVerito, the Kona and the Tata Nexon EV. But can it also be used to charge cars having the early IEC type connectors, like for instance the Mahindra E20 Classic or the Tata Tigor EV?
So these chargers do come with a Type 2 port. So they are predominantly for use for Type 2 vehicles, which is also all the newer vehicles which are launched right now come with a Type 2 port. For the older variants, the IEC port, you would need a Type 2 to IEC adapter in order to charge using the Jolt. But that's the thing. Yeah.
And tell us a little bit more about the software features of the CVAC. What features does it support, and does it have, for instance, scheduled charging?
So coming to the software features, as I mentioned before, the charger is compliant with OCPP 1.6J, which is the global standard for communication of EVACs with the backend. So usually for those customers who wish to set up a group of chargers in semi-public or public locations in order to earn revenue from them, so we do have a full dashboard feature list which they can access. So the owner will get access to an owner dashboard where he can view the chargers under his management. He will also get a full analytics report of all the chargers that he has under his management. So he can also have a page where he can set up user access. For example, if I own a small company and I want to give access to all the employees to my the charging infrastructure that I've set up, so I can easily issue them RFID cards and I can enable and disable all the RFIDs through my admin dashboard itself. So owners can also assign admins with certain rights for chargers. So suppose I have a group of chargers in Mumbai and a group of chargers in Chennai. So I can assign different rates per kilowatt hour that I wish to charge users for accessing the charging services. So those who also set up private chargers will basically be able to access the data through the mobile application. So the mobile application has a map and a list where EV drivers can easily spot what chargers are there in their vicinity and where they can actually go to charge. It also shows the charger status, whether it is available or whether it's in use or whether it is under maintenance. So scheduled charging and smart charging profiles are something that we are working on currently. And they will be launched in the second iteration of the software platforms.
Awesome. And you're telling us about the methods of authentication and the billing and how it would be preserved. Can you tell us about what different types of methods of authentication the EVAC supports?
Yes. So for authentication, we do generally prefer two modes. So by default, the chargers do have an RFID reader and EV drivers are issued RFID cards on request. So you can easily carry it along with your keychain. So once they approach the charger, all you have to do is just swipe your RFID card the charging session immediately is registered to this user. And through your mobile application, all the session data will be, you can view all the session data through the mobile application. The second thing is if the charger also does have a small QR code, which actually has the charger identification number. So EV drivers can actually come up with their mobile application, scan the QR code, and we would actually come to know that, okay, you are a registered user and you're trying to access this charger, and it will automatically authenticate you through the backend. So we do have these two modes of authentication.
Awesome. So that's quite a few different options that are available to people who install these chargers. What are the variants of this charger that are available? Is this the only one?
So BrightBlue does offer a portable portable charger, which also goes up to 7 kilowatt. So this charger is actually a mobile charger, which you can carry along in the dicky of your car. This is not a smart charger. So this is, it basically is for emergency use in case people are going for longer drives. Or if you need to charge at your farmhouse, or if you need to charge maybe at a dhaba on the highway. So this does come with an IEC inlet it has a Type 2 port in the output, which you connect to your vehicle. So this is actually a little bit of a stopgap solution for people who want to go for long drives and are looking for an easy and just a convenient way to charge.
That's great. Yeah. Can you tell us now about the hardware side of it? Where are the chargers manufactured?
So the chargers are entirely designed and assembled in India. The controllers are fully manufactured and designed in-house. And most of our assembly of the actual charging stations, we have a partner in Silvassa who handles those tasks. The controllers for the charging station, including the embedded cords, are fully done in-house. The only thing that we are reliant on foreign components of are the charging cables. So apart from that, all the other components are sourced locally and are designed and manufactured in-house.
All right. So moving on to the commercial side of things, Santosh, we want to understand from you that Bright Blue right now caters to the electric car segment, basically fleets and businesses. Are you setting up any dealerships to promote these EVSEs?
Yeah, so right now, customers who wish to approach us and buy our charging stations can directly approach us at through our website at charge@brightblue.com. So we are in the future looking to establish dealerships and partners, especially for resellers and installers who wish to resell as well as do the installation services for Bright Blue. So we are already tying up with a few installation partners and we already are onboarding them through a training program where we explain to installers the entire process of setting up and installing and commissioning an EV charging station. So once they are approved and once they go through the training, they are they become certified installers for Bright Blue chargers. So we are trying to establish a network of resellers as well as installers so that it can also be a good revenue opportunity for the local community of electricians and local distributors of electrical products. And in turn, it also helps us to grow our business across the entire geography of India.
Satish Reddy from Pune asks, why are AC EVSEs so expensive? We see that many of these start at rupees 40,000 and go up to rupees 1 lakh. Are the components expensive?
So thanks for this question. Yeah. So as it's a good question. So as you see, if you compare the prices of EV charging stations globally, for a smart EV AC charging station, the prices can go anywhere between 60,000 to lakh. So actually at Bright Blue, since we are in designing and manufacturing as well as assembling the chargers fully in-house and these are made in India, so we are actually price competitive when it comes to imported chargers. As well as you also see a lot of chargers coming in from China, at least before the COVID thing happened. So from our feedback that what we have observed is a lot of the chargers coming from China, though they are like cheap, they don't seem to be too reliable, as well as people are not getting enough customer support from these companies. So by actually making the chargers in-house, we are actually giving it at a very competitive price. And also, if you see with the recent make models of electric vehicles coming in with bigger battery packs and longer range, so proper charging standards and safety is required to ensure reliable charging. So we feel that a lot of people do feel that charging needs to be cheap, but having a proper good grade and good quality charger is a must.
So the next question we have from Nupur, who's from Indore, and he says, are there many kinds of connectors in EVSEs and electric vehicles? The IEC 60309 type 2, type 3 pin. And if I get your Bright Blue charger, I will need to use adapters to charge my scooter or car, etc. Do you supply these adapters too? So he's just basically inquisitive about the different types of connectors.
So we do supply type 2 to type 2 cables. But apart from that, as far as it comes to adapters for type 2 to IEC, currently, we don't provide adapters, but we would be happy to help any customers who have such requirements. But what we actually see is for the two and three wheeler market, type 2 is actually not taken off as the charging standard. So for the two and three wheeler market, we do feel that IEC protocol, which is the IEC standard, and the Bharat standard chargers are actually something that works well there. But it obviously doesn't have communication between the EVSE and the vehicle. So we do feel, so we actually do take up certain projects for IEC-based chargers as well. Based if the user has certain volumes that he can give us, then we do take those projects on a case-to-case basis.
So for our next question, we have Mr. Rahul Shah from Baroda. And he asks, where can I see a demo of your charger? Maybe via Plug-in India?
Yes, so certainly. I think so. Before the lockdown, we were actually hoping, to get our products and get a lot of demos done. But unfortunately, due to the lockdown, like a lot of companies, we had to hold our production operations till things at least quieten down and the curve starts to flatten. So hopefully we do expect to give a lot of demos, especially work with Plugin India also to get a demo done. And hopefully we are very excited to put our chargers out there in the market, and especially for users to actually get an experience of charging with BrightBlue technology. So that's something that we are all at BrightBlue are eagerly waiting for, and hopefully it will be very soon.
Awesome. So that brings us to an end of the question and answer session, Santosh. I think you've done quite well. And thank you so much for speaking to us. This really was a deep dive into EVSEs.
Thanks, everyone. Thanks for having me on this interview. It was definitely a pleasure talking to everyone at Plugin India and interacting with the community.
Thank you for being with us. We've enjoyed chatting with you.